When it comes to continuous integration, time is essential. Build caching, the process of preserving the contents of selected files and directories between builds, can save you a lot of time. Every single Bitrise build runs on a clean virtual machine. This means that normally, without caching, everything must be done from scratch on the virtual machine, including, for example, installing your dependencies. For a larger app, this can be extremely time-consuming, but this is where caching comes in. Using caching, you can preserve the contents of selected files and directories, including installed dependencies. And it's very easy. You just need to use two steps in your workflow. The first, called bitrise.io cache push, stores your content in the build cache. The other, called bitrise.io cache pull, pulls the cache the next time you run a build. Let's take a look at how these two steps work. The cache push step has two main configuration options. One, the paths you want to cache, and two, the path you want to ignore. It's easy. In the cache path input, set a path to a file or a directory that you want to cache. In the ignore path from change check input, set a path to a file or a directory that you want Bitrise to ignore. Ignoring means that the particular path will not be checked for changes. Normally, Bitrise checks your working directory, compares it to the previous cache, if there is one, and if something changed, it updates the cache. Ignored path, however, won't be checked. Even if something changed within those paths, the cache won't be updated with the changes. If a path included the ignore path from change check input, it will be excluded from the cache archive entirely. This way you can make sure that specific files or directories won't be cached at all. You can set up multiple paths in both the cache path and the ignore path from change check input. You just need to enter each different path on a new line. The cache path input also has a default value. It's an environment variable exposed by steps that cache certain content themselves, for example, dependency installer steps like CocoaPods install. Now let's talk about actually accessing your cache. A cache is created once you run a successful build with the cache push step. To access it, you need the bitrise.io cache pull we mentioned earlier. This step is very simple. You just add it to your workflow, preferably somewhere near the start, like right after the git clone repository step. You don't even need to configure anything. The step works out of the box. If your build was successful, your cache is ready. It is kept for 7 days. If there are no more successful builds on the same branch of your repository in 7 days, the cache will be deleted. You can also delete it manually. Open the Apps page on Bitrise and go to the Settings tab. Scroll down to the Manage Build Cache section. Click the Manage button, and then you will get a pop-up window with the available cache archives, sorted by branch name. You can either download the cache you need by clicking the green icon next to its name, or delete it by clicking the red icon. And that's about it! Check out our documentation for more info about caching different types of dependencies, and contact us if you need help.